What's going on, YouTube? This is GugaB 2.5, and today I'm going to do my thoughts on the brand new Justin Timberlake album that just came out today. And you all know what album he came out with today. Everything I Thought It Was by Justin Timberlake. This is his sixth studio album. This is his first album in 6 years since Man of the Woods. This album has two singles. The singles on the album are Selfish and No Angels. So you all know how I'm gonna go. I'm gonna talk about the songs, what I like, what I don't like. So here we go. Track number one is Memphis. What a good way to begin the album. This song, I believe, was produced by Danja, who I believe is from, who is a co-producer for Timbaland. Man, this is such a very good song on the album. What a good way to begin this album. Basically, he's talking about where he's from and stuff. Because, you know, Justin Timberlake is from Memphis, Tennessee. And I think Usher is from Memphis, Tennessee as well. I'm not sure. But Memphis is such a good song. I like that deep voice. I'm everything I thought it was. I'm everything I thought I was. I everything you thought I was. I am. Love that song. Track number two, Fucking Up the Disco. This song was produced by Calvin Harris. Yes, Calvin Harris, who did the songs Stay With Me with Justin Timberlake, Huxley, and Pharrell Williams from the Funk Wave Bounces 2 album. I love this song. This is the type of song that you want to play in front of your girl. You know, when you want to go out to a club. That's how good this song is. I love Fucking Up the Disco. Such a good song. Track number three, No Angels. This is the second single for the album. This song reminds me of a Dua Lipa song from Future Nostalgic album. I love this song. This is such a good song. And this is the second single for the album. It is such a good song. I love No Angels. It is such a good song. This song, I believe, was produced by Calvin Harris again, who produced Fucking Up the Disco. Such a good song. Track number four is possibly one of my favorite songs on the album, Play. I don't have anything to say about this song, man. If you listen to the beat of this song like this, was barely 11, stick around, you get a lesson. Peace of him all day, that's that bougie rose. Make that good shit gourmet, gourmet all day. Maybe it's time to play. This train has just left the station. If you listen to that song, this song definitely sounds like something that could have been played in the third From Dusk Till Dawn movie. You know, from Dusk Till Dawn 3, The Hangman's Daughter. If you listen to the beat on this song, the bass, you would definitely hear that in the scene from the third Dusk Till Dawn movie where Rebecca Gayheart's dancing with that vampire and then she gets bitten by one and then she transforms into one, which I thought was sexy. That's what this song reminds is what could have been in the movie, what should be in the movie if it was re-released. Yeah, Play is such a good song. I believe this song was produced by Ryan Tedder, the same Ryan Tedder that did Gypsy Woman and Holiday for Hilary Duff. Yeah, he's on this album, which I thought was pretty amazing. Track number five, Technicolor. This is 7 minutes long, produced by Timbaland. I love this song. This song is kind of like Spaceship Coupe Part 2 because that song was 7 minutes long. I love this song. It is such a great song. Timbaland, it's great to see him back on this album because I wasn't really feeling any of the tracks on Man of the Woods, but you know, it's good for what it is. Track number six, Drown. It's the promotional single for the album. I love this song. I especially love the bridge for this song. The beat on this song is amazing. It is so good. The song, I believe, was produced by Louis Bell and Circuit, I believe, produced this. Man, it is such a dope-ass song, in my opinion. So that's Drown. Track number 7, Liar, featuring Fireboy DML. Not as good as Drown or Infinity Sex, which I'll get to. Yeah, not as good as that song, but this song was pretty decent. This song was produced by Danja again, who produced Memphis. It's decent. It's not as good as track 6, though. Track 8, Infinity Sex, this is produced by Timbaland. This is the perfect song to have sex to. I don't care what anybody says. This is the type of song that just makes you want to have sex, in my opinion. That's just my opinion. I love this song, Infinity Sex. It is such a good song. I just love it. Shout out to Timbaland, because he produced this shit. And I think Calvin Harris co-produced. I'm not sure. Yeah. So yeah, track number 9, Love and War. I love this song. It is such a good song on the album. On in a fight war. I love that song. It is such a good song. Basically, he's talking about what happens in love and war. And yeah, there was a movie in 1996 with Sandra Bullock and Chris O'Donnell titled that. But, you know. Shout out to Timbaland again because he produced it. Track number 10, Centrified, featuring Tobe. After seeing the SNL performance, this is such a good song. I love this song. I love the breakdown on this song. This is definitely bringing me back to Justify, FutureSex, LoveSounds, and the two 2020 Experience albums. Man, that's how good this song is. If this gets released as a single, I want to see a music video for this song. Track number 11, My Favorite Drug, which is produced by the two people I just mentioned on Drown. Oh, and track 10 was produced by Rob Knox. My Favorite Drug is such a good song. Clocking in at 5 minutes, this is such a good song. Basically, he's talking about what his favorite drug is and all that stuff. Track number 12, Flame. This song is nearly 6 minutes long. After listening to this song, I love this song. It's so good. Again, produced by Rob Knox, the same Rob Knox that did Dress On and Body Count and Blindness. Good song. Track 13, Imagination, produced by the same guys I just mentioned. This is another good song on the album. I just love this song. It is such a good song. This song is just so good. I can't say anything about this. Track number 14, What Lovers Do. This is a really good romantic song. Basically, this is talking about what lovers do in real life. That's what he's talking about in this song. Track number 15, Selfish. Oh, by the way, What Lovers Do was produced by Timbaland. Track number 15, Selfish, which is the first single on the album. Fire song. I love this song. Basically, he's talking about his past and all that. I love the chorus for this song. So if I get jealous, I can't help it. I want every bit of you, and I guess I'm selfish. It's bad for my mental, but I can't fight it. I love that song. And I love the music video for this song. It's so good. That's Selfish, produced by the two guys I just mentioned. Track number 16, which is possibly one of the saddest songs on this album, Alone. This is produced by Danja. This is such a sad song. Basically, he's talking about he doesn't want to be alone when his girl is gone. It is such a sad song. I know some people will cry to it, but me personally, I'm not. Hell, I cried a never again from Justified. True story. Track number 17, Paradise, featuring NSYNC, which I'm glad he put NSYNC on this album. I love this song. This is another sad song on the album. This song, in my opinion, is kind of like a continuation of Gone or I Drive Myself Crazy. That's how good this song is. And this song was produced by Timbaland. This is such a good song. Final track on the album, Conditions. What a fantastic way to end the album with a good song. So my thoughts on this album. This is such a good album. After 6 years, after Man of the Woods, Justin Timberlake finally redeemed himself and he finally released a good studio album. This album is amazing. I love this album. I love the beats. I love the production. I love how he got Timbaland back on this album. And I love how he got Rob Knox again. And I like how he got to work with Calvin Harris. And I like how he worked with Ryan Tedder. Yes, the same Ryan Tedder that did Gypsy Woman for Hilary Duff for Dignity and Holiday for Hilary Duff for Dignity for Best Of, excuse me. So yeah, this is a good song. My score for this album is a 10 out of a 10. This album was way better than Man of the Woods. And this is possibly going to be his best album since Justified, FutureSex, LoveSounds, and the two 2020 Experience albums. So yeah, this was a good album. Okay, everyone. I am Grigory 2.5. I hope you enjoyed the video. And peace out, guys. Thank you.